ready? Start. The appellant, comma. Guman Singh. Impulse. Judgment dated 10.3.2017. Passed by the division bench of the High Court of Judicature for Rajasthan at Jaipur, comma, which confirms his conviction under section 302 of the Indian Penal Code, bracket open, code IPC and code, comma, for short, bracket close, for murder of Shiv Charan, and under section 307, read with section 34 IPC, for attempt to murder Babu Singh, full stop. Appellant stands sentenced under section 302 IPC to life imprisonment and fine of rupees 10,000 and in default of payment of fine to serve additional rigorous imprisonment for 1 year and for an offence under section 307 IPC to rigorous imprisonment of 10 years with fine of rupees 1,000 and in default of payment, comma, and additional rigorous imprisonment of 1 year, full stop, para. The conviction arises out of FIR number 464/2009, registered on 30.8.2009 at 8:20 p.m. in police station Hindon City, comma, district Karauli, comma, Rajasthan, and the consequent charge sheet filed against the present appellant, comma, that is Guman Singh and Jagdish Singh, comma, Satvir Singh and Shyam Singh, full stop. Jagdish Singh was acquitted by the additional sessions judge, comma, Hindon City, comma, Karauli, comma, Rajasthan. White judgment dated 7.6.2013 and Shyam Singh and Satvir Singh have been acquitted in the impugned judgment of the High Court, full stop, para. The primary issue oblique question raised before us relates to veracity and truthfulness of the testimonies of Tara Singh within bracket PW1 and Varun Singh within bracket PW4, comma, son and nephew of the deceased Shiv Charan, full stop. Tara Singh within bracket PW1 and Varun Singh within bracket PW4 have disposed that they along with Sivendra Singh were on a motorcycle on their way from Hindon to village Bunky, full stop, para. The deceased Shiv Charan and the injured Babu Singh were on another motorcycle a few steps ahead of them, full stop, near Chob Ka Bandh, comma, another motorcycle with the present appellant Guman Singh and Satvir Singh, son of Ramoli, and Shyam Singh, son of Umed Singh, comma, residents of village Bunky, comma, appeared from behind the and came parallel to the motorcycle driven by the deceased Shiv Charan, full stop. One of the riders from the third motorcycle had then fired a shot that had hit Babu Singh on his side and back, full stop, para. The motorcycle skidded and Shiv Charan and Babu Singh fell down, full stop. Guman Singh had then fired at the chest of Shiv Charan, full stop. Satvir Singh and Shyam Singh too had fired at Shiv Charan, full stop. Guman Singh, comma, Satvir Singh and Shyam Singh had also fired shots at Tara Singh within bracket PW1 and Varun Singh within bracket PW4, who had managed to escape by running towards the Hindon city to save their lives, full stop. They had from STD booth near Chungi informed their relatives about the occurrence, full stop. On seeing a police vehicle, comma, they drove along with police to the place of occurrence, full stop, para. However, comma, this version as to their presence at the place of occurrence and being eyewitnesses to the firing by Guman Singh is a suspect and in grave doubt, comma, in view of the testimony of Guman Navi, within bracket PW7, the investigating officer and SHO, police station Hindon City, comma, who had disposed that on 30-8-2009 at around 5:30 p.m. information was received from an unknown person that someone had been fired upon by another near Chob Ke Band, full stop. PW7 on reaching the spot along with other police officials found Babu Singh lying in an injured condition, full stop. Siu Charan had already died, full stop. One motorcycle was lying at the spot, full stop, para. On directions of Ghulam Navi, within bracket PW7, comma, the deceased Siu Charan and Babu Singh were taken to the hospital, full stop. Ghulam Navi, within bracket PW7, has not disposed and accepted presence of Tara Singh, within bracket PW1, and Varun Singh, within bracket PW4, at the spot at 5:30 p.m. on 30.8.2009, full stop. As per PW7, comma, his first meeting with Tara Singh, PW1, was at the hospital at around 8:20 p.m., comma, when a written complaint was given to him by Tara Singh, PW1, full stop. Upon receipt of the written complaint, steps were taken for registration of the FIR, full stop. Similarly, comma, Babulal Bhaskar, within bracket PW10, sub-inspector, comma, had deposed that on 30.8.2009 at 5:30 p.m. he had left the police station and had reached the hospital at around 5:55 p.m. around 8:20 p.m. he had initiated the proceedings after preparing the panchnama, etc. In his cross-examination, comma, PW10 had testified that till 8:20 p.m. none of the witnesses had disclosed and named the attackers, and they had also not indicated as to the type of weapon used in the offense, full stop, para. On reading testimonies of Ghulam Navi, within bracket PW7, and Babulal Bhaskar, within bracket PW10, we find that their versions contradict the version given by Tara Singh, within bracket PW1, and Varun Singh, within bracket PW4, as to their presence at the place of occurrence and their claim that they were following the deceased Siu Charan and the injured Babu Singh on another motorcycle, full stop, para. Their presence in highly doubtful and their eyewitnesses account apparently conjured, comma, as they were not found at the spot when Ghulam Navi, within bracket PW7, DSHO and investigating officer had reached Chob Ke Band at around 5:30 p.m. on 30.8.2009, full stop. Ghulam Navi, within bracket PW7, in his cross-examination also had accepted as correct that the informant Tara Singh, within bracket PW1, was not present at the place of the occurrence till the time Babu Singh was sent to hospital.